blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song,
my soul, praising my Savior.
Oh,
trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Yonder I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise and the glory of his resurrection share, when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
I'll be there.
Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, Believe in God. Believe also in me. I have children under death, no life, no angels, no personality, no things present, no things to come, no height, no depth, no anything else in the world of creation to be able to separate from the love of God in Christ Jesus from the Lord. We live in glory. He died to the Lord. So that whether we live or whether we die, we're the Lord. For this end, Christ died and lived again. He might be the Lord both for the dead and the living. We brought nothing to this world. Come, we continue to know. The Lord gives. The Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Eternal God is our refuge. Underneath, we have a lot of skill. With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our sister to be prepared. Our sister was responding to the man to the Lord and the Lord. And instead, we offer this great God as our Father, the giver of life, the giver of grace, and the perfection, and the coming of the saints. The Lord be with you. Let's pray. O God of grace and glory, remember the Lord's day, your sister and me. We thank you for your blessed and common friends, the Lord who loves the design of the mercy of God. In your love and compassion, console us more. Give us faith to see death and gain eternal life. So we acquire comfort and make a continual course of learning until we have all the armory and those who come before. In Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. You can see it. We have two tributes. One word and one together, if you know, followed by a new tribute.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming to celebrate the life of Claudine Clark, affectionately known as Mum, Gran, Mums Clark. She had a lot of names. Claudine Clark was born in Wilson Village, Lodge Road, on February the 8th, 1933, and went home to be with our Lord on November 29th, 2022. She was the daughter of the late Gladys and Gordon Clark, sister to Erla, Ovina, Norma, Hugh, Anthony, and Vanda, and the late Denise, Deborah, and Ismay. Claudine attended Vauxhall Primary School. She first worked at Searle's Plantation and went on to work at ICL Electronics. She then worked for many years at Rockley Resort, and her final workplace was the Christchurch Girls' School. Mums Clark was the mother of four children, Ermine, Yvette, Wayne, and the late Roslyn Clark, beloved grandmother to Nigel, Gregory, Dion, Andre, Omar, Fabian, and Fiona, and great-grandmother to seven. Not only was Mum a loving mother and grandmother, but she was also very beloved by many in her community, and especially the little ones at Christchurch Girls' School, who would call her Auntie, as she was always ready with hugs, words of encouragement, and some spare pencils too. During the vacation times, Mum would always have fun things for us grandchildren to do, like taking us to Spikestown for a bus ride and a picnic, and many trips to Miami Beach. It would be Adrian, Gregory, Sean, Andre, Omar, and me, Dion, who was the only girl but the tomboy of the group. Mum loved her children and adored her grands and great-grands. She would always put her children and grandchildren first, to the sacrifice of herself many times. Mums Clark was fiercely independent, and did not like anyone in her kitchen when she was cooking. And she also loved to bake. One minute we will be sitting down watching a movie on a Sunday afternoon, and the next minute we will be smelling fresh bread baking, or she would put together a delicious homemade pizza. Mom was baking black cake up to 2019 and still cooking up until very recently. Mom would go to the beach every day, Monday through Friday, until eventually she taught herself to swim in her 60s using a plastic bottle. You can believe that? That was so impressive. Claudine Clark was the kind of woman who her friends could trust, who would be there for you in good and bad times. Now, she would always speak her mind, as she was a no-nonsense person, but she was also warm, kind, loving, and a generous person who loved her family very much. If there was anything she could help you with or give to you, you could have it. Mom was also a surrogate grandmother to many of her grandchildren's friends, like Sean, Trevor, Kirk, Mark, Colin, Shane, and David, and many others, who knew they would always be welcome in her home. Mom talked to them as a mother to make sure they were going in the right direction as well, because that was the kind of person she was. Mom had such an impact on the lives of those who came into contact, where many were in shock to hear of her passing, as she was such a big part of our lives. Mom Clark was a faithful worshiper at Christ Church Parish Church until COVID hit, but she loved coming to church every Sunday and singing the hymns. She knew her Bible so well, and if there was a passage you couldn't remember, Mom could always give you the chapter and verse you were looking for. And to have Mom pray for you and over you, you truly felt it. The last thing that Mom did before she peacefully passed, she was up early in the morning, reading her Bible and praying as she always did. So she passed doing what she loved. Mom Scott would always end our phone call saying, "My darling, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. We love you so very much too, Mom." Thank you for loving us, for caring for us, for cooking for us, for praying for us, for being the best mother and grandmother and friend we could hope for. Friends, tell your loved ones you love them, hug them tightly. God bless all of you, and thank you for being here to celebrate Mom's Clark life and mourn her passing. Rest in eternal peace, Mom. Thank you. Thank you.
The song I'm going to sing this evening is Oceans, and if you know it, you can feel free to join in and sing as well.
You called me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where feet may fail. And there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith will stand. And I will call upon your name, and keep my eyes above the waves. In oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours, and you are mine. Oh, 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 oh. Your grace abounds in deepest waters. Your sovereign hand will be my guide. Where feet may fail and fear surrounds me, you never fail and you won't start now. And I will call upon your name, and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours, and you are mine. Oh, 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 Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call me. And take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. And I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours, and you are mine. Oh, 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 oh.
Christ, the Lord, who lives and reigns with you and with the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Be seated. Now, our first scripture
reading from the Word of God, written in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 50 to 58. What I am saying, brothers and sisters, is this: flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable. Listen, I will tell you a mystery. We will not all die, but we will all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For this perishable body must put on imperishability, and this mortal body must put on immortality. When this perishable body puts on imperishability, and this mortal body puts on immortality, then the saying that is written will be fulfilled: death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your sting? Is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved, be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord, because you know that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. The word of the Lord.
Our nation is seated. Our stand is thank you.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 14, verses 1 to 6. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and I will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The word of the Lord.
I speak in the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. You be seated. Words taken from the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 1, beginning to read from verse 22. All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. The Virgin will conceive and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us. And they shall call his name Emmanuel, which means God is with us. Let me first of all, on behalf of the parish family here at Christ Church Parish Church, offer to the Clark family our deepest condolences as we pray not only for you, but in this instance that we pray with you. Our sister, part of sister, was a faithful member of this parish, and I was fortunate, felt blessed to minister to her, giving her communion to the sick and shut-in, as was mentioned in the words of remembrance. Prior to that, she was very active, very involved in the singing and praise of Almighty God. So therefore, after COVID, I had to go to her home, and it was saying, I used to look forward, even though, and visit her many times because of certain restrictions, but I look forward to being in her presence because, as you were saying, was going, she was a live wire. A live wire in terms of letting you know her feelings, what she'd experienced in the past, and indeed even to state that as a child, she was told that she speaks too much, she talks too much. But that's what the kind of person that she said what was on her mind, and not only say what was on her mind about her own feelings, but to say what was on her mind about her testimony, about her love for Almighty God. And that's why in those brief times when we gathered in her home, I felt very blessed and honored to minister to her, but in turn that she ministered to me. So therefore, from that point of view, we give thanks for her life and for her witness. And we give thanks for her life and her witness, and to note, from my own experience also, to know that her passing, even though she was senior in age, and of course, when someone is senior in age, you kind of like, at least here, begin to come to terms, or try to come to terms with the fact that they're not going to be with us much longer, but of course, it doesn't deal with here, it also deals with here. It deals with the sense of the heart. And therefore, to hear over the phone, to hear the news of her passing and the reaction, the response of her daughter was very, very touching indeed. So we are here to give thanks, and we know for the family it's going to be a difficult time, not only because of someone who's had a significant impact upon your life, but of course this is a family time of Christmas, and it's going to be especially difficult to say how will we face Christmas, how will we face this family time without Mum, without Gran. Well, I would suggest that you can do it based upon the passage that I just read about Emmanuel, God is with us. Yes, Christmas is a time for family, it is a time for celebration, for gatherings, etc. But essentially, Christmas is a time to speak about the fact that God is with us, and not just with us for 12 days, not just with us in the lead up to this particular season, but God is with us and God has been with you through all the changing scenes of life. And therefore, Ermine and Yvette and Wayne and other grands and other members of the family, we need to know that based upon the witness and the faith of your mother and grandmother, that you will be able to face this particular situation as you've done and had to do in the past when you lost a sibling. You were there because your mother taught you, your grandmother taught you about whatever is going on in our life, that God is with us. He is Emmanuel. And that, I believe, is the greatest gift that someone can give to a family, can give to their children and their grandchildren. To know that while, yes, we try to be there as parents and grandparents, as aunts or family members as best as we can, but we know that we will not be there and cannot be there for all times. And therefore we believe that the best thing, especially if we are people of faith, is to introduce our children and our grandchildren, our loved ones, to the one who will always be there for us. And I would suggest that that's what your mother and grandmother, that she gave that to you as a gift. Now, of course, this time is a time of gift giving, and no doubt it is a pleasant thing to receive a gift. But often, of course, after a while, it's a gift no longer have significance. It may break as a toy, or we outgrow it. But not so, I would suggest, with the gift of Jesus Christ. He's always relevant for our lives. And he will never be broken. It seemed at first sight that he had been broken on the cross. But of course, the important message of the gospel of Jesus Christ is the fact that death, even the cross, did not have the last word. And because he did not have the last word, therefore he could say to his disciples, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me." And our sister took that to herself. And she took that to herself, not only in terms of saying it, but living it. I mentioned the fact that she was a person who spoke her mind. And that, of course, is important, to say what is on our mind, especially if it is the truth. But it's not just to say something, it's to act out something. It's to show by example. And to show by example what it is that we truly are experiencing in our hearts. And our sister did that. And she did that, and this is another aspect about the Christmas season, in fact, the aspect of Christmas. It's not just that the word is spoken, that the word became flesh and dwelt among us. But the word was there for us, and the word came on our level so that we, when we're going through our difficult times, not that we have to think about a God who is in the distance, but a God who is walking with us, a God who talks with us, a God who is there, and a God, as we have said in the words of remembrance, that when we pray, and as our sister prayed, pray for her family, there's a God who hears. And as we therefore are praying for you, family, we know that God will listen to us as he has done so in the past. But we have to pray for each other. Because while yes, we can say wonderful things, we can show our faith, we can thank God for the faith of our departed sister, we have to ask ourselves, yes, she's giving you a gift in terms of not only by word, but to incarnate her faith in Jesus Christ. And therefore, it's left to us. Sometimes, of course, when a loved one dies, especially a mother or grandmother, of course, there's a lot of tears, a lot of sorrow, a sense of loss. Those tears, that sense of loss, doesn't have to be the last word. And therefore, if we truly, truly love our mother or grandmother or a loved one, therefore, let us open the gift that God has given to us, not only for our departed one, but for all of ourselves. And that's why, for you and for all of us, as we entered into this service today, we said something for Claudine and for all of us, if we're prepared to embrace it. And it comes to us based upon the scriptures from Romans, where Paul writes, "I am sure, I am convinced, that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all the creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord." Emmanuel, God is always with us. Because God is always with us, our sister lived out already for this life before the next. And therefore she emphasized the words that have been selected from the hymn, O Jesus, I Have Promised. And the final words, O let me see thy footmarks, and in them plant my own. My hope to follow duly is in thy strength alone. O guide me, call me, draw me, uphold me to the end, and then in heaven receive me, my Savior and my friend. May she rest in peace and arise in glory. Amen.
If your hands, O Lord, will safely command your servant, and now we come to beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming, receiver in the power of your mercy, and the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and the glorious covenant of saints of light. Rest eternal grant to her, O Lord. May she on the favor departed from the mercy of God rest in peace. Now stand, sing a hymn, by the way of the Lord.
Thank you. straight.
Okay.
Straight to the hearse.
Okay.
Thank you.
11, saying, write this, copy the dead, dying the faith of Christ, henceforth of the Spirit, they may take with the rest, take with them the record of their deeds. Man, the born of a woman, has a short time to live, like a flower, he blossoms and withers, like a shadow, he flees and never stays. In the midst of life and death, to whom can we turn to help? But you, Lord, are justly angered by our sins. Assure us of the hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. We commend to Almighty God our sister Claudine, and we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ash to ash, and dust to dust. And we beseech you, in your infinite goodness, to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor. And when your well-beloved Son should come again in judgment, that this our sister will be ourselves and found acceptable yourself, grant us for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved, the spirit of faith and courage, and may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfast temptation. But sorry is those without hope, for it is time to remember your great goodness and the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Bless eternal ground to her, O Lord. May she know the faith of depart to the mercy of God, rest in peace. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift his countenance upon her and give her peace. It is well with my soul, and we all get to heaven when the rulers call at yonder and as they journey through the land.
Thank you. Yeah.
sent us, told us, before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Amen.